I'm suddenly getting more spam emails. Should I be worried? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Ask Leo is brought to you free in part because of the support of my patrons. askleo.com/patron has more information about how you can help and get patron exclusive content. Let's get right to the question. I recently began receiving 100 plus spam emails per day, mostly sexual related. Gmail is doing a good job sending them to spam. I would assume someone has gotten my email address that I wish hadn't. Should I be concerned about them having more than just my email address? No other obvious sign of phishing, etc. No, in general, you don't need to worry, unless, of course, you're seeing other suspicious activity beyond just getting spam. Let's face it, this happens all the time to all of us. You don't even have to have a particularly active account. All you need to have is an account and you'll start getting spam. Let's have a quick look at one of my example accounts. This is askleoexample@hotmail.com. And you'll see that the inbox itself is completely empty. But if I take a look at my folders, you can see I've got 1,000 pieces of junk there. That is at least within the last month. It's quite a few per day. And if I go in there, you can see it's the standard, scams and spam and who knows what all, just stuff that's all worth ignoring. But there's just hundreds and hundreds of spam emails here. Like I said, we all get it. If you have an email account, you're either getting spam or you're going to be getting spam. It's kind of the way the email ecosystem works. Now, one of the things I want to address, you've indicated that your spam is getting routed to the spam folder by Gmail. That's fantastic. That is the system working as it should. There's nothing you can do to stop the flood of spam. All you can do is decide how you're going to manage it. And a spam filter, a good spam filter that automatically and correctly the majority of the time identifies spam and places it into a special folder, usually called either spam or, as we've seen here in Hotmail, junk, it will save you the need of actually ever having to even see the spam. Those 1,000 spam messages that I just scrolled through, probably the first time I've seen most of them. A few show up in my inbox, and that's kind of sort of to be expected. One of the measures of a good quality spam filter is how many false negatives, in other words, how many spam actually make it into your inbox, and how many false positives or how many legitimate emails make it into the spam folder. Outlook, it's okay. It has a varying success rate. It really does require some amount of attention. It's a filter that generally will err on the side of caution. And by that, I mean it will let spam into your inbox rather than running the risk of falsely marking something as spam. Gmail seems to be the best spam filter out there so far that I've seen. It does a really good job of identifying spam and throwing it into the spam folder so that I rarely, if ever, actually take the time to look at my spam. There's simply no need. Like I said, that's the system working as it should. Whether you get one spam a day or 1,000 spams a day, if it all ends up in your spam folder, that's okay. That's the way it should be. If it's not, if it is not showing up in your spam folder, if it is, if you are getting 1,000 spams every day in your inbox, you need to find a different solution for spam management. That usually means switching to a provider with a better spam filter. Gmail seems to be the best free one. I have to point out again, you cannot stop spam. Anyone can send you spam. If they know your email address, they can send you an email. That means spammers are going to send you email. There's really nothing to prevent that from happening. All you can do is manage it as it arrives with a good spam filter. So why do we suddenly get these floods? I've seen them myself. One day I'll get 20 spam, and then for the next 3 or 4 days, I might get 30 or 40 or 100 spam, with no real apparent rhyme or reason to it. I've got a couple of theories. One is that a new breach has somehow made its way into the spammer circles. By that I mean one of the breaches that you may or perhaps may not have yet heard of has become public information for spammers to use. They immediately then grab the new list of email addresses that they've discovered in the breach, which probably includes yours and mine, and then start spamming it aggressively sometimes. That is one reason you might suddenly see a large flood. Another is that honestly, spam, which used to be kind of a random hit or miss, low level kind of activity, has kind of turned into its own business, its own little cottage industry. And as a result, spammers run, I'll just call it campaigns. They might have contracts with people for whom they are sending these emails out, and they may periodically be sending large batches of spam on behalf of some of these companies that are trying to sell you stuff. It is another reason that you might end up seeing spam come in waves. But waves themselves, spam itself, is honestly not really something to worry about. It's something to manage. But no matter how much you get and how much it gets managed properly, spam in and of itself does not indicate a security issue for you. It does not indicate anything is really at risk. Someone knows your email address. Many people do. It's just not an issue. What is an issue if you also start seeing other things happening? If you do see suspicious sign-ins to your own email account, if you do see activity on your credit card that you don't expect, if accounts start getting opened in your name, then it might be time to take further action. Pay closer attention to what else might be happening in your digital world. That could mean anything from credit monitoring services to simply changing accounts or keeping a very close eye on your credit card. Exactly what to do? Well, that'll depend on exactly what suspicious activity you see. But the good news here, the real takeaway here, is that spam, annoying as it can be, is generally not something to worry about. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/137545. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.